CSS properties are some of the most ubiquitous artifacts in web development. You can't really develop anything for the web without editing its CSS properties. There are some 500 CSS properties, though the most commonly used of these narrow down to a few hundred, and it is these most commonly used properties that we aim to document for the beta release of web platform docs. And we're excited to have third parties like Adobe Brackets and Chrome DevTools using this information in their products. This video serves to supplement the information you'll find on the CSS property project pages. In other words, yes, you'll still need to read the Web Platform Wednesday doc and the CSS property editing guide to be prepared to contribute to this project. Once you're ready to start, visit the Web Platform Wednesday page to choose some properties and tasks to work on. Every Wednesday at 11 o'clock a.m. Pacific Time, 7 o'clock p.m. UTC, we gather on the Freenode IRC channel, pound web platform, to go over the list of properties designated for the week. You can either post to the channel with the properties and tasks you want to work on, or you can send an email to public-webplatform@webw3.org. You'll be contacted by a coordinator who will help you work on the project, but you don't have to wait until Wednesday to get involved. Send an email anytime. Wherever possible, choose a group of related properties so you can take advantage of any cut-and-paste shortcuts. For example, Rob Simpson has signed up to work on several text decoration properties. He sent an email to public-webplatform@w3.org, and coordinator Julie edited the table to sign him up. You won't need to edit this table. Just stay in contact with the coordinator as you work, and the coordinator will update all the record keeping. Often you'll have a group of related properties that includes a shorthand property. Think of the shorthand property as the master property of the group. For example, the text decoration property is the shorthand property for the text decoration color, text decoration line, and text decoration style CSS properties. Once the coordinator has signed you up for the property, click on the link in the table and open the properties page. If the link is red or the page does not exist, contact the coordinator. If your group of articles includes a shorthand property, work on the page for the shorthand property first. You'll need to refer to the W3 specifications. Pull up the spec cited in the fourth column of the table, then search the page for the property you are working on. They moved it to a different spec. This sort of thing happens a lot with specs. They're constantly changing. Also, be sure you're referring to the most up-to-date spec. At the top of the specification page, there are listed all of the pertinent versions. Use the latest editor's draft spec. In-page search is your best friend. Notice that the shorthand property is described after its component properties. This is typical. Note also that the specs contain a lot of superfluous information. This is because they are intended primarily for browser developers who are implementing the standard, not necessarily for application developers and designers using the standard. Your job is to distill from all of this information just what a developer or designer needs to use the property in an application. We'll go over how to include this information in your doc a little bit later in the video. However, not all the information about the property may be found in the spec. Review other documentation sources for more information and to get familiar with the property. As you find information in other sources, be careful to use it only in a manner that does not violate any copyrights or license restrictions. Don't plagiarize. In web platform docs, we always provide content attribution when information is drawn from external sources. See the editor's guide for more information about license and copyright issues and external attribution. We'll go over external attribution in greater detail later in this video. While CSS properties are the focus of Web Platform Wednesdays, you can sign up to work on specific tasks for CSS property pages, or you can sign up for all tasks on a given page. The tasks are documenting basic facts, explanatory text, creating examples, links, and reviewing complete articles. The basic facts include the values in the overview table, the syntax, and the property values. You can copy and paste these values and descriptions from the specs as they are. The spec says, for the animatable value, see individual properties. Usually, if all of the longhand properties are animatable, the associated shorthand property is animatable too. You should always test it. Ask the coordinator if you need help testing properties for animation. For the CSS object model property, this is usually the same name as the property, with the hyphens removed and the words combined with camel case, as shown here. By the way, you can ignore the percentages field. Notice that the border style value none has a link to more information about background image here in the W3C spec. Be sure to pull all that information into your documentation. In this example, that the image layer counts but is not drawn when the value is none. And include a link to the related WPD page. In this example, the background image CSS property page. In other words, be sure to include all relevant supplementary information in the value descriptions. Notice also that we use code formatting to style the text for other property values described. In the hidden property value description, the words none and hidden are formatted as code to set them off from ordinary text. Once you have all the values documented, the syntax section displays them as code syntax automatically. The explanatory text in the summary, usage, and notes sections is where you will contribute to your original content. You will contribute your original content, gleaned from your research in the specs and related documentation. Here, it is really important that you contribute only original content, no cutting and pasting verbatim from other sources. The article summary should briefly describe the property. If the property is a shorthand property, the summary should say so and link to all of the properties associated with the shorthand property. The usage section provides guidelines for using the property, and any little gotchas not obvious in the descriptions. Notes describe considerations for how the property works, usually beyond the user's control. Don't worry about the important notes section. This is just an artifact from the initial content import. Now for the funnest part, the examples. Keep these super simple. Save the complex, fancy examples for a tutorial another day. Your example should demonstrate this property only. Don't introduce other properties or make the example dependent upon the knowledge of other properties. Also, the example should be self-explanatory. To create an example, start with a new codelet at code.webplatform.org. First, I save as new to create a new codelet. This will assign a file name to the codelet. Then I replace the dummy content with my own. You should test your example in all of the major browsers. Watch out for deviations from the spec when you run the example. It turns out that dotted lines in Chrome are composed of square dots instead of round ones, as they are in Firefox. I'll go back and adjust the description accordingly. We want to catch and document these little deviances and details wherever we find them. In this example, I've set up an element to demonstrate each value. However, you can also set up your examples to be more interactive. In this example, the values for the property are provided in the comments, so the user can just plug them in and play around. But that's about as complicated as you should make your example. Don't get carried away with creating drop-down menus for all the values, or otherwise building a playground app here. That will only clutter the code and distract the user. Once you have a nice working example, copy the pertinent code back into the page for the property you are working on. Notice I'm only including the CSS code, not the HTML, here in the CSS property documentation. Also, copy the URL from the codelet example to the live example URL field, which will be the value for the view live example link in the published doc. To create a link to the W3C specification, under related specifications, copy and paste the title of the specification into the name field, the URL for the spec into the URL field, and the status level into the status field. Some properties belong to more than one specification, so be sure to include references to each specification. You can skip the compatibility sections. We're replacing these with automated data. In the See Also section, skip the topic clusters. These two are getting an overhaul. In the Manual Links field, include cross-references to related CSS properties and other internal resources, such as tutorials from the CSS Tutorials page. In the External Links field, include any references to relevant external content. In the Topics section, check the box for CSS. Don't check any other boxes. In the External Attribution section, leave any checked boxes the way they are, and if any of the content you contributed came from an external source, check the box for that source and include the link to the source in the link field. That's it for the edits for now. Remember, you can always come back later and edit some more in case you remember something you've forgotten. If you are not the reviewer, be sure the Needs Review checkbox in the High Level Issues section is checked. If you are the reviewer, make any corrections or additions to the content as needed. Once your review is complete, uncheck the Needs Review checkbox. If any other High Level Issues checkboxes are checked, please resolve the issue and uncheck the box, or note the issue for your report back to the coordinator for Web Platform Wednesdays. When you're all done editing a page, under Edit Details, enter a summary of the work you've performed and click Save Page. If you're working on CSS Properties as part of Web Platform Wednesday, be sure to note how much time you spent on any particular property and report that back to the coordinator. Also, note any issues or concerns you have with the content and report that back as well. Also, please, please, please tweet, post, or otherwise communicate through social media channels like Facebook and G+ and Twitter. We want to get the word out. And that completes the exercise. Thanks for contributing. Your time and expertise are invaluable, and your contribution to Web Platform Docs and the greater community is making the web successful.